Hi there. An industrial PoE switch is the ideal solution to use in a harsh environment, such as outdoor applications, manufacturing plants, and oil rigs. So what's the difference between the commercial PoE switch and the industrial PoE switch? That is what we're going to find out today in this video. And also, we're going to set up a small network with an industrial PoE switch at the end. But before we jump to the video, please subscribe our channel, FASTCABLING, and hit the bell icon so you won't miss any of our updates. An industrial PoE switch is designed for a harsh environment. That's why it should be able to withstand extreme temperatures. Most of the industrial PoE switch has extended temperature range from minus 40 degrees to 75 degrees, some even up to 85 degrees Celsius. On the other hand, the commercial PoE switch has a limited operating temperature range from only 0 degrees to 40 degrees. So the commercial PoE switch is supposed to just sit in a rack with an AC temperature control on. And you also have to make sure you let the hot air out of the commercial PoE switch. The extreme working temperature not only comes from the switch design, but also the robust component. Usually, the industrial PoE switch is more expensive than a commercial PoE switch. The industrial PoE switch doesn't have a power source built in. That's why it needs to use external power supply unit to power the switch. A power supply unit will generate heat. That's why the heat will accumulate in the commercial PoE switch. So using an external power supply unit will reduce the temperature inside the box. And some industrial PoE switch even support redundant power supply unit. If one power supply unit is down, the other one will take over immediately. That's why we have no breakdown between the transaction. Now, let's move on to the demonstration board and we'll set up a redundant power supply unit. So here we are at the demonstration board. This is the 8-port industrial PoE switch. Not only can supply redundant power, but also a hot swap. So you don't need to turn off the switch in order to replace a new power supply unit. Now we can see the PoE switch is already connected to the camera and the camera is alive through the fiber optic cable. And we already have one power supply unit connected to it. Now we're going to add another one. To save time, I already connect this side. Now we only have to connect this side. And make sure you put in the right one, the red one to positive and the black one to negative. Now let's screw it tight. The DC power is DC 54 voltage, so it's pretty low and safe. And now it's all set and we can plug in the power. And you can see the power light is on and the camera is still on. And now we're going to unplug the other one, the first power supply unit, and the camera is still alive and on. So no matter which plug you plug off, the camera is still working. So it's pretty easy, right? So we are set and done. So to deploy industrial PoE switch outdoor, you have to put everything in a waterproof enclosure. But if you don't want to put them in the enclosure, you need to use an outdoor PoE switch with the same component. Now, I'll recommend you to watch another video on how to install an outdoor PoE switch. And thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.